Dear students, this is our 16th lecture on named reactions, and today we will discuss what is Tickei olefination. Basically, this is a reaction for formation of a new carbon-carbon bond. The Tickei olefination or Tickei reaction is the reaction of aldehydes with organochromium compounds like chromium chloride in presence of iodoform or bromoform to give us alkenes as the product. And here basically the product formed is a vinyl halide from the reaction of aldehydes with chloroform or iodoform or bromoform. And here the main advantage of this reaction is that the product with E configuration is formed in major amounts. So we can see that the reaction is anisoselective in nature, and the product with Z configuration is formed in lesser amount as compared to product with E configuration. And because of this, this Tickei olefination or Tickei reaction is an alternative to very important reaction like Wittig reaction, where we get a mixture of E and Z configuration, and one of the enantiomers is not formed in major amounts in those reactions. So as far as mechanism of this reaction which was proposed by Tickei is concerned, that in the first step, iodoform reacts with chromium chloride in its 2 oxidation state, and chromium 2 is oxidized to chromium 3 with the replacement of one of the iodide group. And then this intermediate with chromium 3 reacts with another chromium 2 molecule, and we get carbodienoin complex like this on reaction with aldehyde with this chromium 3 intermediate. And this carbodienoin complex which is formed gives us the final product with E alkene as the product. Now, in recent years, in addition to this mechanism, a radical mechanism has also been proposed by Legrand. Here, according to Legrand, a free radical is formed from iodoform on reaction with chromium 2. Chromium 2 iodide is formed, and this type of free radical is formed, which further reacts with chromium 2 to give us the chromium 3 intermediate, which was also formed in the first mechanism which was given by Tickei. Then this here it reacted with another molecule of chromium 2, but here this intermediate directly reacts with the aldehyde to give us this type of intermediate having one chromium 3 attached to the oxygen. Then this further reacts with one more molecule of chromium 2 to give us this type of free radical, which then reacts to give the same type of intermediate which was proposed by Tickei. But only difference over here is that here the mechanism follows the free radical mechanism, and then this carbodienoin complex gives us the product with E alkene as the major product. Some of the important application the Tikai has been reported that in one of the modification, the product with Z configuration can also be formed as major product when ortho substituted aldehydes, that is salicylaldehyde, they are used, and probably because of the hydrogen bond formation due to the presence of this hydroxyl group at the ortho position, the product formed is having Z configuration in the major product instead of E configuration. So this is an exception to what we have seen under normal circumstances, where we get the major product as the E product. But here, the major product formed is Z product, and Z configuration product will be formed as major product only when we are having ortho-hydroxy substituted aldehydes. They are used for olefination. Then one more modification of Takai is Takai-Yutimoto olefination. And here, in this modification, instead of iodoform, we have used substituted alkyl groups on the iodoform instead of one of the group is replaced by alkyl group instead of iodide group. So when alkyl iodides, they react with chromium chloride under these conditions, then we get these types of products, with the major product being the E product having 84% yield in comparison to Z, where it is having only 16%. Then few more common examples of Takai olefication is the selective synthesis of E configuration products over here, and we can see that tertiary butylsilyl group is not affected by these under these conditions, and only aldehydic group is affected for the formation of E alkenes or E vinyl iodides as the product, and here also E product is formed as major product, and E to Z ratio is 20:1. Similarly, in case of porphyrins having nickel at the center, so these types of porphyrins having aldehydic group, they are again converted into vinyl iodides again in E configuration of the product is formed in 75% yield, and no other carbon nitrogen double bond is affected in this case. So here also, this is a selective olefination reaction which takes place only on the aldehydic group. Then in the third example, where we are having methoxy-methyl-ether group as a protecting group, and an ester group is also present. Here also, the olefination is a selective olefination, where the aldehydic group is oxidized to vinyl iodide, or olefination takes place at the aldehydic group in presence of iodoform and chromium chloride. And these two groups, the methoxy-methyl group, ether group, and the ester group, they are not affected by the olefination of the aldehydic group. So this again is a selective reaction for the synthesis of vinyl iodides from aldehydes through Takai olefination reaction. So these are the references which have been consulted for preparing this lecture. Thank you very much.